I am Marion Buricatu, a French and American artist. I am also an art teacher at the Hopkinton Center for the Art and a docent at the Worcester Art Museum. This video is going to make you an art expert in less than 10 minutes, a little bit longer. So, because we are going to tell you the epic story of moving the chapter house from France to the United States with my guest and daughter, Domiti.
Hi, Mom.
So we will be covering three facts that are very easy to remember and fascinating. Okay, so Domiti, what are the stories behind
this video?
This video, yes.
Okay, so story number one is your trip to the chapter house in France.
Yeah.
Story number two is how the chapter house fell into ruins. And then story number three is the trip from the Loire Valley to Worcester, Massachusetts.
Yes, so here is a picture of the chapter house at the Worcester Art Museum. It was built in the 11th or 12th century and it was from France.
Okay, so let's start with story number one, which is your trip to the chapter house.
Yes, so I had an unexpected and personal connection to the chapter house that I really, you know, I didn't know about. When I became a docent in 2018, I discovered the chapter house at the Worcester Art Museum. And I noticed how very close it was from my hometown in France, in the western part of France.
Mm-hmm.
So one summer, I decided to look up the name of a village on Google, and I was able to find the small tiny village, but I couldn't find anything about the ruins. So I thought it would be a good idea to go on a day trip with my parents and the kids. And you were not here that summer.
Yes.
So I figured I'd just find some ruins in the middle of the vineyard. I would take a picture and in 10 minutes we would be just done. And then I promised that after that, I promised to the kids that after that we would go to a nice restaurant.
No offense, but that doesn't sound like a very good plan.
Yeah.
Finding some ruins in the middle of vineyards.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, the restaurant sounds great. I will give you that.
Yeah. And it didn't happen that way.
Of course not. So, yeah. What a surprise.
Yeah. So we arrived in the village where there was only four houses left. And we asked people who about the ruins. And it happened that the people we asked about the ruins were members of the family who owned the ruin.
Okay,
the ruins. And so they were super happy to welcome us, especially when I told them that I was a docent at the Worcester Art Museum. That was the magic pass, okay? And also, I learned that the owner of the ruins, of the whole property, in fact, was the guest of the Worcester Art Museum in the 80s.
Wow.
So he went there and he visited the place and he saw the chapter house. So that there was quite a story there.
That is super interesting.
Yeah, yeah. So they offered us coffee and they wanted us to have lunch with them. And I could see that the kids were not happy. But me, I had a great time.
Yes, I can imagine my brother and my sister giving you death glares.
Yeah, I'm surprised I'm still alive. And so the daughter of the owner, yes, was there, and she gave us a fast tour of the premises, and she showed us the ruins of the church, she showed us the cloister, and she also showed us where the chapter house was. And it brought the whole room to life. And for me, it was so important because I always feel like in the museum, this room is kind of like isolated, and understanding the whole story brought it to life. And I feel like when I give tours, I try to tell that stories.
That sounds like you give a pretty amazing tour of the
chapter house. I feel like people, you know, they can see how it was.
How passionate you are about it.
Yeah, and I bring pictures and everything.
Wow. Do you bring snacks? Okay, let's move on to story number two. How did the chapter house fall into ruins?
Okay, so by the early 18th century, it was already in ruins.
So that's the early 1700s, and that's at least, well, that's a good amount of time before the French Revolution, which was in 1789.
Yes.
So it had been abandoned for a while.
Yes, absolutely. And now we're jumping right into 1881, which means that we are like a century after the French Revolution. And at that time, there was only five houses left in the village of Berry.
Wow.
Yeah. So you remember I said to you it used to be a very dynamic community because there was a priory and there was the whole village around it.
Okay. So it takes 12 months in a whole village to raise a child?
And a chapter house.
Okay, so what happened to the priory, like basically the religious buildings themselves after they got abandoned.
So the religious buildings were sold as a private property to a family of farmers, and I think that at some point they even used a chapter house as a dormitory for animals.
Sleep and comfort.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, so how did that chapter house end up in Worcester then?
So that's the next story.
Okay, so let's get started on story number 3, which is the trip from the Loire Valley to Worcester.
All right, so are you ready for a bumpy ride?
Yes.
On the sea. Okay, so 1925, Paul Gouvert, so that's the French way to say it. The English way would be Paul
Gouvert.
Gouvert, yes. So he was a French art dealer and he buys the chapter house from the family who owns it.
So you mean he bought the entire priory? So he bought the church, the cloister, the chapter house, and the buildings that were part of the priory?
No, that's the thing that is kind of hard to fathom, because he only bought the inside of the building where you had the chapter house.
I didn't know you could do that.
Yeah, yeah, that's strange. Yeah, and as you can see on the picture here, on the right is the building that contained the chapter house on the first floor. The building still stands. And the grey building in the shadow is the church in ruins.
Wow, that's very interesting. So yeah. Can you tell me also a little bit more about this art dealer, Paul Gouvert?
Okay, so he was quite a character. And I think that nowadays we could definitely say that he was a crook. But at the time, okay, you know, there was less rules. So he was a trained sculptor.
He wasn't a statue.
Okay, let me say it again. He was a trained sculptor.
Mm-hmm. Good job.
I said it right?
Yes.
Okay. And he repaired what was damaged or redid what was missing. And he even modified original structures when he thought that was necessary.
All right, so he had no concerns for historical accuracy.
Absolutely no concern for yes. What mattered at that time? Just to repair things, you know. So he even sold a piece to 2 different people and he sculpted copies to satisfy his client. What's the problem with
exactly,
that?
Exactly, he's a businessman. He's just trying to make a living.
Yes, poor guy.
Okay, so he bought the chapter house in 1925 and then what happened?
So 1926, Paul Gouvert sold the chapter house to George Gray Barnard.
And who is that?
Oh, I'm sure that everybody knows this guy. So he was a renowned American
sculptor.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
You know, I'm not gonna say it. And he was passionate about French medieval architecture. So in 1927, he sells the chapter house to the Worcester Art Museum. And so what's gonna happen is that they're going to ship the Worcester, they're going to ship to Worcester in 100 of cases, each block of stone of the chapter house.
Wow. By yeah. boat.
By boat. Yes, ship. By boat.
Yes.
Yeah. And so each stone is going to be marked to indicate its place in the reconstruction with a number, which is kind of unbelievable. And so there is even one place that is marked with a number. And if you come to one of my tours, I'll show you the number.
Very interesting.
Yes.
Okay, so then was the Worcester Art Museum built the chapter house as soon as they got it in 1927?
No, the Worcester Art Museum rebuilt the chapter house in 1933.
Okay.
And so now, Domiti, you remember at the beginning of this
series,
you say that these were boring old stones.
Yeah.
So do you think it was an interesting story?
Well, we are still talking about a staff room.
Yes.
So...
Yeah, yeah. But it was kind of like fascinating.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And so I want to finish with a grandiose end, you know, and tell you that the Worcester Art Museum, okay, was the first museum in the United States to have a medieval room.
And the first U.S. museum to have a Monet painting.
Absolutely. That was quite an avant-garde.
Looks like it's a gem,
yes.
This Worcester Art Museum.
Yes, a
and
gem.
Everyone should visit it.
Yeah. And come to my tour.
Exactly. So let's do a summary of the 3 facts that we learned that are easy to remember.
Oh, yeah. Fact number 1.
Is that you traveled to the village of Berry and you met the family who owns the chapter house.
Yes, and it was unbelievable. And we still ended up going to the restaurant.
Nice.
And fact number 2.
Is that the chapter house was in ruins long before the French Revolution and then was eventually sold as a private property to a family of farmers.
Fact number 3.
The chapter house was rebuilt by the WAM, the Worcester Art Museum, in 1933. And that makes it the first museum in the United States to have a medieval room.
Yeah, unbelievable. And now an extra fun fact about George Gray Barnard.
So a reminder that he was the one who sold the chapter house to the Worcester Art Museum. He was an avid collector of medieval art, and in 1925 he sold his entire collection to John D. Rockefeller, and that became the initial collection for the Met Cloisters in NYC, which is a super famous museum. And if you want to see what a cloister looks like and what the chapter house would have been attached to, you should go visit it.
Yeah.
We will go eventually too. We have not gone.
We still have to be there. We really need to go. Okay, so now you are an art expert in the story of the chapter house at the Worcester Art Museum. I hope you really enjoyed these three videos about the amazing story and its epic trip to the Worcester Art Museum.
Of the chapter house.
Of the chapter house, yes. And so the next video is just for you because we have created some fun trivia question about the trip.
All
the
right.
trip.
Yes.
Okay, bye-bye and see you at the next video. Bye.